G'day everyone, David here, RF Shop. So we've been doing quite a few tests on the outside, just demonstrating the principle that external antenna can definitely help in improving your mobile internet, specifically with the data service, because that's where our main focus is through RF Shop and the external antennas with the modems and so forth. What I want to do now is focus a bit more on the actual antennas themselves, just here in the workshop. Just trying to demonstrate the antennas, what they are, how you can open them, and what you can expect when you get an antenna, what else you need to order to get an antenna to match your specific equipment. So what I have here, I'm in the workshop, so this is just a setup we have. I have a GoPro, so this will have a view of the table as I open a box. And today I want to spend some time on the antenna that I currently find quite useful for us. There's obviously a lot of antennas I have tested, but this is the DR11, or we call it DR11. It's the wideband directional antenna on our website. So let me get into it. Okay, so the DR11, the wideband directional antenna, comes in a box like this. So it's a brown box. Just a brown box. And inside the box, what you will get when you order the antenna by itself is an antenna in a bag and some brackets and an L bracket. So in there, there's a lot of L brackets. So what you do with this, if I just put this aside, you would take the antenna out of a bag. You see at the back there, there's a few holes. Now this bag is closed, so I will show you what you do. There you go. Nuts and bolts in the bag. U-bolts and the L bracket. Let's take one on the actual antenna itself. So with all the brackets and so, we can go into detail how to mount it, but what you would see is basically a setup like this. So you have the right angle bracket, as you can see there. The angle bracket has the U-bolts, and that gets connected with the nut and the bolt with two mounting holes that are on the actual assembly itself. Now I use slant 45 in this case, because this is the setup that I use when I use two of these antennas, similar to this. So you have two antennas in this setup. You can have the option to have a single antenna, which is just a single antenna by itself. You can mount it vertical, you can mount it horizontal, or you can mount it at 45 degree either way by using the mounting holes that's available on the bracket itself. In this case, what I built, and this is the previous video that I have shot, I used this setup, so I have two antennas using the brackets like that in the same configuration, but at the end, the antennas end up being plus minus 45 degree to each other. Now this setup is available as a MIMO setup on our website as well, or as a single antenna. When you take away this one, there's a single antenna option on there. Now what you need to take into account here is the antenna by itself comes with an N-type connector. So it's a setup, it works, it's good. But if you want more cable, on our website there is an option to go for a 5 meter or 10 meter or a 15 meter extra cable. That's basically giving you the option to just add more cable. Now we will deal with the actual cable losses. So don't worry about, can I go for 50 meters, can I go for 10 meters. That's what we do every day. So we will use the cable that is most suitable for that specific cable length, which is a custom cable solution that we offer as a company as well. Now the other thing on our website that you need to see is the option for what type of pigtail you want. So if you do nothing, or well, nothing means you basically have no explicit selection, we assume it's an SMA connector, but it does say that in the cable itself. So SMA connector is on many modems, D-Links could have them. You would see it on Huawei B525, the one that I've been using on my demonstration. Teltonika modem has SMA connectors. So there's many connectors that has SMA, modems that has SMA. But the other option is TS9 connector. So you can see the TS9. So we have these ready-made pigtails in the white there. It's an SMA female on one end, so that would go onto the actual cable itself that we already made. And TS9 would go into modems such as, and I'm thinking here about the Netgear Nighthawk that Telstra offers, the new Huawei B818 that's available, I think Vodafone and Optus at the moment. But TS9 is always an option. Now there are other connectors as well. There's the CRC9, there's the TS5, so there's a whole lot of connectors. So one thing with RF Shop you need to just remember always, We do custom cable. It's one of our biggest product sellers, which is really what is custom cable. It's any coaxial cable specifically we make. So we say 5 meter, we say 10 meters, but if you need something in between, if you need any weird number, if you have any other different cable requirements, just give us a call on our website. There's a phone number or an email address. That's what we do every day. So we have no problem helping you with your specific cable requirement. Now, another thing on this specific antenna that is that we often get asked is, how low does it go? The model itself has changed over the course of the last number of years, not just from us, but this specific form factor and antenna can be seen from many suppliers, and you could see it online as well. It is now ready for all frequencies in Australia. So what we specifically wanted to find one that didn't stop at the wrong frequency, but it goes down to the band 28 700 meg frequency range, and it goes up straight to 3 gig actually. So we can use this for quite a lot of applications, which I will call out now. But first I just wanted to show you how we measure the antenna itself to make sure that it works. Not the full measurement, just the basic one to make sure that this is at least matched to the correct frequency. Impedance matching, just basically that means the antenna is at least functional and it's radiating at those frequencies. So we have our cable tester, which it has a VNA, vector network analyzer function. So we use that to test the VSWR, voltage standing wave ratio of the antenna. I also often call it return loss, but depends on the measurement you look at. So what I have it here set up as is to test VSWR. The machine itself is set up to run from basically from the low end, so 2 megahertz up to 3 gigs. So what I want to show is this antenna just operating. I'm just holding it away because otherwise it radiates against the structures. I have a marker at marker one. I'll just take a screenshot of this as well so I could show you. So the antenna at marker one is 700 meg and the VSWR is measuring 1.27. So it's below 1.5 and that's my personal limit. Often people would say 2:1 is okay. I say 1.5:1 I find acceptable. So this antenna is way out perfectly fine at 700 meg and it definitely works well. A silly test we do, it's professional, but it's not, you can't put this in a science paper to say I've done this. It's a wavy test. You just wave your hand in front of the antenna or wherever you think you want to see it. And if it responds, if there's movement on the actual curve itself, you know that the antenna is at least radiating and it's reflecting from your hand back into the system itself. And you can see the antenna is very alive, very happy. From the back, not so much, which that means if you look at the back, not much happening. From the front, there's a lot happening. So this antenna is directional in that direction. That's all we can do if you just sit here with this type of machine. You obviously want to go further into the measurements that I've done in the chamber earlier. So that's the antenna. Just demonstrating this antenna definitely does band 28 without any trouble at all. So this antenna is really wideband, which means it can be used for a lot of applications. Of course, as I mentioned so many times, the 4G LTE is the main focus, but because it's such a wideband, it also runs over 2.4 gig. So 2.4 gig, this is an absolutely perfect device. It can be used for Wi-Fi and if you want outdoor Wi-Fi range. If you like what we do here at RF Shop, it's we have a YouTube channel, it's growing, so thanks for all the subscriptions, but anybody else who's watching this, please consider subscribing. If you have any technical questions about coaxial cables, connectors or antennas, feel free to let us know through our website rfshop.com.au. We also, with antennas, we deal with more the design side of it. So blackarttechnologies.com is another company that you may want to look at. It's still us, but it's more us as a consulting and design company. We are active on Facebook and Twitter. Of course, that also goes to Instagram. So you're welcome to like us and follow us on those platforms as well. Other than that, thanks for watching and please make comments and subscribe to the channel and let us know how, if you have any specific topics you want us to discuss. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later. Thanks. Bye.